to love. Tell me whatever happened to love.
Right, we're talking to Brew about his new LP, Legacy. And before we start talking about these, the second track, Whatever Happened to Love, I don't even need to tell you, Brew, what the order is, because you know what the order is. Legacy, great name, by the way, not just a sort of greatest hits. Why, you know, I suppose, go on, you tell me, why'd you go with Legacy rather than just the greatest hits of Brew?
I think Legacy is a more interesting title as opposed to greatest hits, you know. And how do you know? I mean, they could be personal faves for all I know, or they could be, I mean, the audience's favorites, you know. But I thought, you know, when I was speaking to the you know, the record label, you know, we're all thinking, oh, Legacy. This album has to show your legacy. And I thought, that's it. That's a title. Let's call it Legacy instead of Here We Go Again, greatest hits. You know, like when I see, I know personally, when I see greatest hits, unless I really love the band, I won't buy it. Never mind. Yeah. Click on it and open it to see what the listing. I just say, but then Legacy kind of makes it kind of this lasting impression, because in a way these songs are kind of like, you know, some of these songs have lasted two decades. You know what I mean? And so I guess in itself that's a legacy. They've withstood the test of time. And what do you know? But I wonder, is the next set going to be called Legacy 2? Or
yeah, yeah, next. What happened next, Chapter 2? But yeah. I must say, I listened to this Whatever Happened to Love, and I really loved it. I love all the tracks on it. And this again, to me anyway, felt like sort of like, you know, nearly like, I wouldn't say like Shakespeare, Love's Labour's Lost and all of that. It really like heartfelt, What Happened to Love? So well, again, what's the story? What's the story behind it?
I think it's about, I wanted to call it Whatever Happened to Lust.
Yeah.
But then they said apparently that wasn't too PC. I'm like, yeah. What? You know, I'm like, you know. Okay, well, this song, to me, obviously, power ballad, whatever you want to call it. I have yet to get that power ballad production on it achieved. But right now, the original version is a very... almost a cinematic version, like a movie soundtrack. Mm. You know, I think it's the keyboards at the end that were. We did this song in Jam Studios, in Kells, County Meath. You know.
Lovely.
And the engineer put these kind of cinematic kind of keyboards in there. You know, almost like strings. And I said, wow, it sounds like a movie soundtrack. You know.
And when you're say writing or whatever, like. Is that, like, say, for instance, if we're talking about Whatever Happened to Love, is that what comes into your mind? Did you write, you know, okay, you wrote it as a ballad type, love ballad, but yeah. Like that's where you say about production, does that just happen in the studio, or do you say, no, I feel a real cinematic feel to this?
Well, I didn't think cinematic at all. It sort of happened. You know, when you hear those strings at the end there, whatever, you know, it gives the song a whole different vibe. And the vibe to me, like, for lack of a better word, was, oh, movie soundtrack. I said, oh, this is a movie soundtrack. But it's not like I sat down and said, okay, I'm going to write a movie soundtrack. Because you never know what song ends up in a movie.
But that's what I love about you, and, you know, talking to sort of other musicians as well, like that.
Yeah.
That I know, don't take this the wrong way, but like what I'm saying is that you're not very particular about the song. Like if somebody says, oh, let's bring in some violins, let's make it more cinematic, you're sort of, you know, you sit back and go, yeah, that could work, man, let's have a listen. You're not very, oh no, I wrote this as a acoustic guitar.
Yeah. I know some bands and some writers are like that. They can pre-plan, like I said, I mean, I'm lucky if the guitar's in tune and I'm actually on point with everything I'm doing on the performance, and then I listen to the end product and it's, oh, okay. And sometimes one might start off as a ballad, could turn to a, you know, a hard rock song or something. But Whatever Happened to Love is definitely, it's been one of those timeless, elegant songs that, you know, again, a lot of rock bands, they just don't play ballads during their live set, you know. But then again, what do they remember most when they go to the show? They remember the ballad, because that sticks out like a sore thumb almost. Mm.
Yeah, because
ballad, you know, and
yeah, and as you say, it's sort of like, sometimes with those sort of like ballads and rock ballads, they're timeless. Is that like, oh, you, yeah, you playing it in 30, 40, 50 years?
Oh yeah, look at Aerosmith. You know, even some Zeppelin songs. You know, the on the surface they're love songs, but they're these big giant ballads. You know, I mean, you know, Bon Jovi. You know, and I'm even. You know, whatever.
Yeah.
I mean, actually, it's funny because sometimes when I perform "Whatever Happened to Love," I kind of throw in some Bon Jovi lyrics there, and it's like, "Wait, is that a Bon Jovi song?" And it's like, "Yeah,
Yeah.
we wrote together back in the day when we were in high school." Yeah.
But probably what it does show is the influence. Your influence is very, very wide, you know.
Oh yeah, I mean, it takes balls to do a ballad, you know, and then you know, and then when I did that song at the Pride show, that was amazing because again, the theme of that song fit in perfectly for that particular show because it's all about, you know, loving each other, whatever. And this, we need more love in the world, you know what I mean?
Yeah. And
And this is like that.
I suppose now, you know, like it must be great for you. You probably find people when they come to your shows, probably that's the song that sticks in their head.
Oh yeah, well, yeah, that in some way, because I mean, I actually some way and whatever happened to love got me the publishing deal.
That's
You
great.
know, my first publishing deal, it was kind of like, you know, and it wasn't like the publisher wanted all the songs. He said, okay, he happened to choose two of my biggest songs. And there's got to be a reason for that. I mean, well, it only tells me the song is good. I'm not quite sure what the reason is exactly, but you know, because why did they not pick two rock songs or something? You know, but then again, whatever happened to love? I mean, it is a rock ballad, you know, but eventually that will have to be redone so we can really elevate it to that status, you know, because it's dying for it, you know, and the more I perform it, you know, it's definitely, it's trying to, you know,
Morph into something else.
exactly, you know, but again, to me, it was just a song. I'm just like, oh, you know, it's like, oh, why can't I score? You know, but then they probably thought I was talking about drugs.
Yeah. But
Yeah.
look, what we're gonna do is now people are probably saying, look, let's hear what the guys are talking about. So listen, let's have a listen
Okay.
to Whatever Happened to Love.
Down my pint. I tell you the way I think my life is going. You listen to me, but you really have no way of knowing. Oh, I need to tell you now. What would it take to come clean now? The part where the bonding is to start. There I'll be on my own again, my heart and hands, my only friend. Whatever happened to love? Tell me, whatever happened to love? Whatever happened to love?